We want to calculate the sample standard deviation of the data shown below to two decimal places. The standard deviation is a measure of variation based on measuring how far each data value deviates or is different from the mean. And here are a few important characteristics. The standard deviation is always positive. The standard deviation will be zero if all the data values are equal and will get larger as the data spreads out. Standard deviation has the same units as the original data, and standard deviation, like the mean, can be highly influenced by outliers. In order to calculate standard deviation, we'll follow these steps here. Step one, we find the deviation of each data value from the mean. In other words, we subtract the mean from the data value. Step two, we square the deviation. Step three, we add the squared deviations. Step four, we'll divide by n the number of data values if the data represents the whole population. And we divide by n minus 1 if the data is a sample. Because we're asked to find the sample standard deviation, we'll be dividing by n minus 1, shown in the formula here below. And then finally, we compute the square root of the result, which gives us the standard deviation. So going back to our example, I've already done some work to save some time. So this first column are the data values. So we need to find the data value. So the first step is to find the deviations, which would be the data value minus the mean. So notice below I determined the mean, or x bar, by summing the data values and dividing by the number of data values, which was 6, which gave a mean of 20.5. If the mean doesn't terminate, we should include at least 3 or 4 decimal places for accuracy. So notice the second column, x minus x bar, we started with the data values and then subtracted the mean. The next step is to square the deviation. So we took the deviations here and then squared them in the next column. From here, let's set up the sample standard deviation formula. We would have s equals, and then we'll have the square root. We'll have a fraction under the square root, where the numerator is going to be the sum of the squares of the deviations. So we'd have 0.25 plus 72.25 plus 12.25 plus 6.25 plus 20.25, and then finally plus 30.25. Now we're determining the sample standard deviation, so we'll divide this sum by n minus 1. Again, there are 6 data values. 6 minus 1 would be 5. And then we take the square root of this fraction, which will give us our sample standard deviation. And now we'll go to the calculator. So we'll have the square root. And now we'll put the numerator of the fraction in parentheses. So open parenthesis, 0.25 plus 72.25 plus 12.25 plus 6.25 plus 20.25 plus 30.25. There's the numerator, so we'll have close parenthesis. And notice how the denominator of 5 is still under the square root. So we'll press divided by 5, right arrow. And again, notice how the entire fraction is under the square root. So we'll press enter. And to two decimal places, we have approximately 5.32 for our sample standard deviation. So going back to our first slide, we enter 5.32. I hope you found this helpful.